On November 27th of 2022, the Mauna Loa volcano in Hawaii began its first eruption in more than 3 decades, joining the also erupting Kilauea volcano on the Big Island. It is now day 5 of Mauna Loa's eruption, and although some of the following information is unofficial, we now have a decent idea of how much lava has erupted. The U.S. Geological Survey estimates that between 100 and 300 cubic meters of lava is erupting every second. My own estimate fell within this range, as I believe that approximately 94.6 million cubic meters of lava has been erupted since the beginning of this week at an average rate of 249 cubic meters per second. This is indeed a high lava effusion rate, but if confirmed, is not completely unexpected. Molten rock is being ejected onto the surface at 2 unusually long fissures, which are each more than 1,000 feet long, and instead of each consisting of pinpoint eruptions of molten rock, the entire fissure is erupting, hence videos showing simultaneous lava fountaining along a chain of activity. This means that in only 5 days, Mauna Loa has erupted more lava than Mount St. Helens did in a period of several years during its last eruption between 2004 and 2008. Of course, although Mauna Loa is still erupting, it does not appear to have the same intensity that was witnessed during its first 12 hours. Regardless, lava flows have already covered a little more than estimated 4 square miles or 10 square kilometers. While the lava flow from Fissure 3 is still advancing towards Hawaii Route 200, it, as expected, rapidly slowed in the last 48 hours due to a gentler slope further away from Mauna Loa's summit. Whereas beforehand, its A'a flow was moving at a rate of 427 feet or 130 meters an hour, it is now moving at an incredibly slow 131 feet or 40 meters an hour. And, despite the volume of erupting lava, this advance could further decrease in the following days. Assuming that lava continues moving at its current rate, it will take until next Thursday to reach and then cut off Route 200, but even this is not guaranteed. As of 1 p.m. Hawaiian local time on December 1st, the closest flow of lava is 3.2 miles or 5.2 kilometers away from the aforementioned road. Due to all of this activity, Fissure 3 has seemingly built a chain of loosely defined spatter cones due to the sheer volume of erupted material. These spatter cones are elongated along the length of the erupting fissure. Spatter cones commonly form during effusive eruptions with no or minimal ash, which more famously also formed during the August 2022 eruption of the Fagradalsfjall volcano in Iceland. In other news, the U.S. Geological Survey has published results on the composition of Mauna Loa's still erupting lava. They stated that the lava was erupting at a temperature of 2,113 degrees Fahrenheit or 1,156 degrees Celsius, which is within the range of temperatures expected for molten rock of a basaltic composition. The lava contained small crystals of both olivine and plagioclase feldspar and had about 6.4% by weight magnesium oxide. Overall, this is quite similar to compositions from Mauna Loa's other historical eruptions. As a final note, here is some footage courtesy of a livestream from the Two Pineapples YouTube channel where he was able to spot a number of pieces of Pele's hair deposited from Mauna Loa's ongoing eruption. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Nick Ash for supporting this channel.